President Biden's proposed budget for the fiscal year 2023 is out, and as expected, it includes the largest military budget that the planet has ever seen. $813 billion for 1 year of military spending here in the United States. An $813 billion giveaway to the military-industrial complex. And by the way, that's actually not hyperbole. The White House is urging Congress to approve $145.9 billion for procurement, funding that will allow the military to purchase 61 F-35 jet fighters from Lockheed Martin Corporation, fewer than previously planned, as well as the B-21 bomber from Northrop Grumman Corp, and two Virginia-class submarines from General Dynamics Corp and Huntington Ingalls Industries. That's actually verbatim from the budget. Like, the war profiteering in this country is so ingrained in us that we're just straight out spelling it out in the actual budget itself. Saying, hey, we got to make sure Lockheed Martin gets theirs, Northrop Grumman's got to get theirs, General Dynamics has to get theirs. If there's anybody we left out, please contact us. We'll make sure you get a big piece of the pie too. And that is what's happening here in the United States. Earlier this year, we were told that we don't have the money to keep handing out those extended child tax credit payments. You know, that would be socialism. Can't take care of our own people. We're told that forgiving all of the student loan debt that remains out there in this country, just too big of a price tag, right? Too much of a good thing. We, of course, can't have universal health care because that's just way too expensive. Debt-free college? Oh, God, no. But $813 billion for 1 year of military spending? Not a peep. Well, of course, there are peeps from the usual people like Bernie Sanders and a handful of others. But this budget will pass. The military will get at least $813 billion, if not more than that, because Congress typically likes to throw in, you know, tens of billions of dollars more than what is usually asked for, just because, hey, why not? You guys are doing a good job. Here's an extra $20 billion. This past year, they just randomly gave them an extra $31 billion because why not? They didn't ask for it. They apparently didn't need it. But Congress just said, hey, here's a little bonus for you. People in this country are dying because they can't afford their medications. And they're being told that we cannot afford to make their medications cheaper for them or make them free for them. But there's always money for guns. There's always money for jets and bombs and tanks. There's always money for the military-industrial complex, and none of these people who ask us, how are you going to pay for it, for things like universal health care, raise a peep when we continuously, year after year after year, raise this military budget to the point where I believe by the next administration, we will have a $1 trillion per year military budget, if not sooner. And let's not forget that officially, on paper, right, the United States is not at war. We are not at war. And we're proposing the largest military budget that planet Earth has ever seen. As people in this country go hungry, as people can't afford their medications, as they ration their insulin or try to hop the border to try to get it for cheap, there's always money for war. But there's never enough money to actually help people who need it. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.